head coach Jay Norvell is back in the headlines again. If you've never heard of Jay Norvell, well, either did anyone else until he had this to say about Coach Prime and his mama.
And I sat down with ESPN today, and I don't care if they hear it in Boulder. I told them I took my hat off and I took my glasses off, and I said, when I talk to grown-ups, I take my hat and my glasses off. That's what my mother taught me. So
Colorado was already hot after a 2-0 start, but Coach Prime responded by hyping up his team even more with the bulletin board material.
I'm minding my own business, watching some film, trying to get ready. Trying to get out here and be the best coach I could be, and I look up and I read some bull junk that Deion said about us.
Talk to us.
Once again.
Talk to us.
Why would you want to talk about us when we don't talk about nobody? All we do is go out here, work our butts off, and do our job on Saturday. But when they give us ammunition, they done messed around and made it what? It was just going to be a good game.
And it made this shit personal.
They done messed around and made it
personal.
It was going to be a great test, a battle of Colorado, but they done messed around and made it personal.
The Buffaloes went on to win the Battle of Colorado in double overtime. After the game, with much anticipation, the two head coaches met amongst the mayhem to convene an icy exchange. The bad blood between the two sides continued to fester. Months later, following the defeat, Jay Norvell's wife commented on X, calling Shedder Sanders a B for his confrontational behavior, flashing his Rolex at her husband after the game. All this means for a great rivalry game between Colorado and Colorado State, set for September 14th, next season in Fort Collins. Interestingly enough, Coach Norvell recently revealed that he has more pressing issues to resolve, more so than the Sanders family and the Buffaloes. This is Plumber Football, because there is only one way to succeed in anything, and that is to give it everything. Jay Norvell is desperate to fend off Power 5 teams from poaching his top players. We don't want to be a farm system for the SEC or the Big 12. That's what's happening right now. Coach Norvell is coaching through the fog of the transfer portal and NIL deals taking center stage across the country. This is getting wild, and we're still yet to truly know how pay-for-play will ultimately manifest itself and shake up college football forever. The implications of the transfer portal and NIL are significant. It affects everyone involved in the sport. The professionalization of college sports is not coming, it's here. Coach Norvell has a plan to slow down the intrusion, however, keeping wealthy programs away from Fort Collins will continue to be a challenge, where the Power 5's insatiable appetite demands the best athletes available. Will schools like Colorado State become farm teams for the Power 5 schools? Should players remain loyal to their institutions, or should they capitalize on their apparent value? We'll discuss it all here. Colorado State starting quarterback Braden Fowler-Nicolosi has reportedly turned down an offer of a $600,000 NIL deal to leave CSU football. It has not been disclosed as to which teams were interested in the services of this emerging quarterback. In 2023, Colorado State's total passing offense ranked 9th in the nation, led by this former 3-star quarterback from the state of Texas. On 3, national scouting services have elevated Braden's rating to 4 stars as a college player. Though his trajectory is headed in the right direction, Braden is still not considered an elite college quarterback yet. But as a quarterback, he is still in position to receive a massive payday. The current going rate for high-profile college quarterbacks like Shedeur Sanders starts at $1 million and can grow to as much as $5 million. As for poor Coach Norvell, it's not just his starting quarterback that's being enticed to leave. Norvell told the Coloradoan, "Our top 12 players on our team have all had offers to go other places. One of these players is Torrey Horton, a top wide receiver prospect in the 2024 NFL draft. Last season he led the Mountain West Conference for the second year in a row with 96 receptions, and with 1,136 receiving yards finished second in that department. Like his quarterback Fowler-Nicolosi, Horton decided to decline a six-figure offer to leave. So you may be wondering, what is the Power 5 in collegiate sports? And what advantages do they have over schools like Colorado State? Power 5 is the five most elite level conferences in college football. These conferences include the Atlantic Coast Conference, ACC, Big Ten Conference, Big Ten, Big 12 Conference, Big 12, Pacific Coast Conference, Pac-12, and Southeastern Conference, SEC. Most athletes that are drafted into the NFL come from the schools that make up the Power 5. Power 5 has larger revenue, budgets, and television viewership than other college athletic programs. So, the NIL collectives they can put together are generally going to be more substantial than what other programs can provide. Simply put, Power 5 programs can draw upon more resources to compensate high-caliber players. With the financial might of Power 5 programs and a lack of oversight from the NCAA, the door is wide open to capitalize, harmonizing the NIL and transfer portal to each institution's advantage. Potential players are generally sought through intermediaries such as a high school coach, parent, or anyone with a connection to the player. We're doing all we can to fight off a lot of these wolves that are trying to poach our roster and take our young players, says Coach Norvell. You see, member teams of the group of five conferences like Colorado State in the Mountain West are all susceptible to the poaching that Jay Norvell is shedding some light on. Football coaches fear losing their players. They spend time developing them just for them to be lured away for another institution's benefit. For the most part, Coach Norvell will rely on the Colorado State University NIL collective called the Green and Gold Guard to better compete against outside threats. A collective is an organization used to provide NIL opportunities to athletes at that school. Collectives pool funding from donors to help provide those opportunities. Coach Norvell sent a sobering message to all those that love CSU football saying, "We've got to get involved with it or we're going to fall behind. That's just the reality of it." It won't be easy for the group of five conferences to retain their best and brightest players. For most players, they understand that their chances of making it to the NFL are slim to none, so now with NIL at play, players are trying to cash in while they can. According to a 2020 study from the NCAA, the estimated probability of competing in professional athletics. Only 1.6% of collegiate football players will ever play in the pros. Other CSU players like cornerback TJ Crandall and receiver Lewis Brown have entered free agency via the transfer portal. Crandall recently visited UCLA. Like it or not, these kids deserve to be paid for what they contribute, not just the coaches and administrators. Players are the cornerstone of college football and its chance of success present and future. Let's use Braden Fowler-Nicolosi for an example. As a non-resident undergraduate student on campus, Colorado State University is technically looking after his tuition, room, and board for a grand sum of approximately $50,000 a year. In days past, this $50,000 annual scholarship was the enforced and artificial ceiling on Fowler-Nicolosi's true value. Any attempts to monetize himself outside of scholarship funds could violate confusing NCAA provisions. Thankfully for the player's sake, NIL happened, and now the open market can say, "Fowler-Nicolosi, we would like to compensate you with an annual sum of $600,000 to be a quarterback on our roster." That's an 1,100% increase. That's like Jay Norvell on his $1.6 million base salary. And a program comes along and says, "Mr. Norvell, how would you like to go from $1.6 million to $19.2 million instead? We just want you to be our head coach." What would Coach Norvell do? Are we to believe that Braden Fowler-Nicolosi and Torrey Horton just walked away from massive paydays? What we believe truly happened was that head coach Norvell got in touch with the Green and Gold Guard NIL collective and found a way to take care of his key players. At the very least, CSU was able to minimize the gap between themselves and outside offers to a point where the difference bore little consequence to the athletes. If somehow we are wrong about our interpretation, then Braden Fowler-Nicolosi will need a competent personal advisor immediately. We'd like to see programs keep the athletes that they develop, but we believe that as NIL deals and the transfer portal continues to evolve, Group of Five conferences are destined to continue to have their players poached. Colorado State has their green and gold guard, but each institution also has their own. The bidding wars will benefit the players as it should. With the national appetite for American football, the ceiling to which NIL deals will plateau is unknown. Whatever players decide to do when confronted between lucrative NIL offers or remaining loyal to teams who compensate them with less or nothing, we should support their decisions. What they're doing is exercising their free will allotted to them by the NIL. It's a beautiful thing. Thank you for watching. For more videos on the NIL transfer portal, like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. Do it now before you forget. This is Plumber Football, because there is only one way to succeed in anything, and that is to give it everything.